हेलो, दिस इज लेक्चर 5 बाय रामानंदन सर। डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। सो लेट अस सी दी Theorem 2, it was Theorem 1 already in Lecture 4, whereas now Theorem 2. Theorem 1 we discussed in that Lecture 4, which is the derivatives of sum of two vector functions. Similarly, the difference, the derivative of difference of two vector functions. Statement: if a bar of t and b bar of t be two vector functions, B2 differentiable vector functions, of a scalar variable t, then prove that d by dt of a bar of t minus b bar of t is equal to d by dt a bar of t minus t by dt b bar of t. That the proof of the theorem proof let a bar of t and b bar of t be two differentiable vector functions of a scalar variable t. Next, let f bar of t is equal to a bar of t plus minus b bar of t, and then f bar of t plus delta t is equal to a bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t plus delta t, increment in t. Next, by definition of derivative, by definition of derivative, d by dt of f bar of t is equal to limit definition, limit delta t tends to 0, f bar of t plus delta t minus f bar of t whole divided by delta t. This is the limit definition of the derivative. Implies d by dt of substitute f bar of t we are taken as a bar of t minus b bar of t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0, So f bar of t plus delta t, it was there, a bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t plus delta t minus of f bar of t is a bar of t minus b bar of t whole divided by delta t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0. Arrange the terms now, a bars at one place, a bar of t plus delta t minus a bar of t minus of b bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t whole divided by delta t. That is equal to limit, apply the limit for each of the two terms, the bracket terms. It is of limit delta t tends to 0, a bar of t plus delta t minus a bar of t whole divided by delta t minus limit delta t tends to 0 of t plus delta t b bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t whole divided by delta t. This is equal to, by the definition, the first term is d by dt of a bar of t minus second one is d by dt of b bar of t. Thus, d by dt of a bar of t minus b bar of t is equal to d by dt of a bar of t. That means the derivative is separate for the two vector functions, d by dt of b bar of t. Right, theorem 3. Theorem 3. If a bar of t and b bar of t be two differentiable vector functions of a scalar variable t, then prove that d by dt of a bar of t dot b bar of t is equal to a bar of t dot d by dt of b bar of t plus d by dt of a bar of t dot b bar of t. So it was given 2017, but in 2019 it was given like this, 2019, that will be 2020 in the corona period. D, show that d by dt of a bar dot b bar is equal to dA bar by dt dot b bar plus a bar dot dB bar by dt. So this was the theorem statement. Next, proof. Proof. Let a bar of t and b bar of t be two differentiable vector functions. Bt differentiable vector functions of a scalar variable t. Next, let the procedure is same as discussed in theorem 1 and theorem 2 almost. Let f bar of t is equal to a bar of t dot b bar of t. And f bar of t plus delta t is equal to a bar of t plus delta t dot b bar of t plus delta t. By definition of derivatives, d by dt of f bar of t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 f bar of t plus delta t minus f bar of t divided by or whole divided by delta t, that is equal to or implies left side is d by dt of f bar of t value is a bar of t dot b bar of t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 f bar of t plus delta t is a bar of t plus delta t dot b bar of t plus delta t minus of f bar of t is a bar of t dot b bar of t whole divided by delta t. Here a term can be add and subtract. Limit delta t tends to 0 a bar of t plus delta t dot b bar of t plus delta t, this is as it is, so the term can be subtract. A bar of t plus delta t dot b bar of t plus subtract and add the same term, a bar of t plus delta t dot b bar of t, and the remaining is minus a bar of t dot b bar of t. This is as usual, that was already in the theorem statement, whole divided by delta t is equal to limit delta t tends to 0. Now in these two terms, a bar of t plus delta t is common. So a bar of t plus delta t dot is common. The remaining is this one, b bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t. Next, from these two terms, dot b bar of t is common, so that the remaining is plus of a bar of t plus delta t minus a bar of t dot b bar of t. In these two terms, dot b bar of t is common, so that the remaining is a bar t plus delta t minus a bar of t whole divided by delta t is equal to, as delta t tends to 0, the first term is to be a bar of t dot, apply the limit to this term, whole divided by delta t is, it is like this, limit delta t tends to 0, that should be, the remaining term is here, b bar of t plus delta t minus b bar of t whole divided by delta t plus, coming to here, apply the limit, limit delta t tends to 0, a bar of t plus delta t minus a bar of t whole divided by delta t dot, right, the remaining is, as delta t is not there, so that it should be, the term is to be as usual, b bar of t. This is equal to a bar of t dot d by dt of b bar of t plus da bar by dt d by dt of a bar of t dot b bar of t, or simply it is d by dt of left side is d by dt of a bar dot b bar is equal to a bar dot db bar by dt plus da bar by dt dot b bar. It is theorem 3. Similarly, theorem 4, we have theorem 4 we will discuss in the next class. Again, that is also important one. Thank you. Thank you very much.